Hello friends, welcome back to Westward Study. In this video, you're going to see all the preparation tips, strategies, as well as the standard books which you need to follow in order to crack UPSC Mains 2019. So now let's begin our video. So coming to the first tip, maintain a good timetable. Good timetable in the sense you have to prepare the timetable based upon your knowledge. That is, for example, if there are four different subjects and out of four different subjects you're very weak, just imagine you're very weak at one of the subject, then you have to prepare your schedule, the timetable, in a way that you have to give most of the time, like maximum of the time, to that particular weakest subject. Okay, this helps you to score more marks in UPSC Mains 2019. And the second most important tip is that syllabus keeps changing each and every year. Even this year, there are minor changes in the syllabus pattern and everything, like the syllabus, updated syllabus. So make sure you have the knowledge about the updated syllabus of UPSC Mains and follow that. And coming to the third important tip, focus on the basics. Okay, so most of the students start preparing the difficult level questions and all, and they forget that 90% of the questions you can easily answer or solve just with the basics. Okay, and the fourth important tip is that while revising or while preparing or while studying, you need to concentrate on maintaining a short notepad, and in that you have to note down each and every important point, and before going to sleep, you have to keep revising each and every night, because this helps you to remember those important points for long. Okay, so coming to the next important tip is that each and every day you need to at least read two standard newspapers, and you have to at least watch 1 hour for any news channel. Like, at least for 1 hour, if you watch the news channel, you will be updated in your current affairs as well as the general knowledge. So coming to the next important tip, there will be many mock tests available online, so you can go and attempt those mock tests as well. Why? Because if you give mock tests, it helps you to analyze your performance. So the next tip is that at least collect last 10 to 12 year previous year's paper and keep revising them as well, because 40% of the papers will have the repeated questions. So, and the another important thing about the previous papers is that once you have the previous year's papers, you even can understand what sort of questions they are repeating every year, what sort of questions they are asking every year, and what is the difficulty level of the questions. Okay, so, and also concentrate on your speed. Okay, while attempting the exam, time management is very important. Now coming to the strategy, what you need to do is while presenting the answer, write the answer like clearly, like, you know, you have to present the answer in a way it explains each and every point. You have to think the examiner does not know anything. Okay, for example, just imagine they have asked you a question to write in the exam, and you have to think that the examiner does not know anything. You have to write answer so clearly such that the person who does not know the concept will understand each and everything about the concept. Okay, it should be that clear. And the second important thing is that you have to practice on your writing speed and your writing skills as well, because handwriting should be good. Your time and the speed of presenting the answer should be really fast, and also you have to try to enlarge the answer. Okay, so most of the students will have the doubt, like the answer size should be small, or like it should be like an essay. And my answer for this question is that whatever you know about the concept, whatever you understood about the answer, please write each and everything try to attempt the answer to the maximum size. And also another important tip is that most of the students will ask whether to present the answer in a form of points or paragraphs. I suggest you to write in the form of points with neat headings, underlines, and also use the bullets, you know, the star mark, arrows. Use all this to make the answer attractive, to make your presentation attractive. Because if it is a paragraph, the person who is correcting your paper, the person who is reading your paper feels bored, obviously. Just keep yourself in the place of examiner. What we feel while correcting the answers which are in a paragraph and which is so lengthy, okay? So we understand it, right? So I suggest you people to attempt the answers in the form of points. Use bullets and bullet means, like, you know, the arrow. It's just like an arrow, okay? And star marks, circles, use like the small points. Use all these things in order to make your answer look good, okay? So this is the tip. Now let's see. What are the standard books you need to follow for this particular exam in order to crack UPSC mains 2019? So first of all, for culture, okay, for the subject culture, you need to follow India's Ancient Past, which is by R.S. Sharma. It's one of the best book and it's one of the standard book. One more book for culture is that The Wonder That Was India, okay, by A.L. Basham. It is also one of the best book for culture. Now, coming to the geography, follow Geography of India, which is by Mazid Hussain. And also follow Oxford School Atlas, which is by Oxford for geography, the best books ever. And coming to the history, follow History of Modern India and India's Struggle for Independence, the standard books which all know, everyone know. And coming to the economy, please follow Indian Economy by Ramesh Singh and also Economic Survey. Okay, these two are the standard books for economics. Coming to the geography, Certificate Physical and Human Geography, which is by Go Cheng Liang. It's the standard book. So coming to the current affairs, the best thing is to read everyday's newspaper, watch news channels every day at least for 1 hour, and also follow India Yearbook. Okay, you'll have each and every current affair present in that, the standard book. So coming to the ethics, you have to follow Lexicon for Ethics, Integrity and Aptitude. Follow this particular books, and for governance, follow Governance in India for CSE. Okay, it's for CSE. So follow these books. And coming to the polity, use like the politics, use India Polity for Civil Services Examination, which is a standard book. So these are the standard books which you can follow in order to get really good marks in UPSC mains 2019. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos. Like and share this video in order to encourage me, encourage my work, my hard work. So thanks for watching. All the very best. So if you want me to make any more videos regarding UPSC mains or UPSC interview and all, you can feel free to comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this video. Subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified whenever I make a video. Please like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching and all the very best for your UPSC mains. Be confident. Keep revising, work hard. There is no substitute for hard work. So please work hard. Please be confident. And that's it. Thanks for watching.